So he rolled a mage archer. Now, I'm not going to go into a lot of detail because pretty much everything I said over in the mage is pretty much the exact same. What a mage archer differs is the ability to farm more quickly. They don't have to worry about attack speed by putting stuff into attack speed because they will get frenzy. The empower weapon helps with damage. I mean, power weapons is good, but I mean, it's not as good as like getting extra points as mages do, but it is good. It helps. But with Corpse Explosion, you're able to farm a lot more quickly. Now, that all changes once you get to, if you're going to be farming higher R's and you're going to be using a multi-missile. So, it's only applicable if you can orb farm. So, if you can use your orbit to kill stuff in one hit, then Mage Archer is going to be the best type of farm. So, other than that, it can do a lot of damage, not as much damage as the Mage. I mean, there's always the choice between the Mage Archer and the Mage. I mean, there's always been that debate. Now, it's just your preference, what you want to do, how you want to do it, stuff like that. So, neither is wrong, neither is right. It's based completely on preference. I mean, what you're going to be doing, you're going to have some extra points too. So you put them in the mage tree, in the archer tree. You're basically going to be doing empower, frenzy, dodge, and corpse explosion. Those are the ones that you want. And then anything else, you know, the normal stuff in the mage tree, anything else is just lanyap. Whatever you want to do. Like, I have extra stuff in mana bomb and things to build it up, so I can just switch gear and play a mana bomb build. But Mage Archer is a lot of fun. It's an in-game build. You can use crit with it, you can use bleed with it, you can do whatever. Same thing with the mage. They are so much alike, but they do have different abilities and different things to make them shine in certain situations, and then in other situations they can't perform as well. So you will have a little bit extra defense, not much with the Mage Archer. With the RNG dodge, that's about it. Other than that, I can't say anything bad about the Mage Archer. It's great. The reason I place the Mage Archer above the Mage is because of the ability to farm better. And when you're farming, of course, you're farming lower level stuff, so you're killing things in one hit, and you don't get as much diminishing returns on damage. So you're able to farm more quickly and more efficiently. But that's the only reason. There's nothing really else. And the the whole fiasco with the astral set and no longer desyncing orbs really, really hurt Mage Archer and Mage. I'm just going to say it. You can't, neither can farm as well. So that's just, until they fix that, it I don't know. It really pisses me off. I don't really farm with my mage anymore. My warrior farms more quickly. Or if I do farm, I farm with multi-missile at higher levels. But yeah, that's the Mage Archer. Pretty straightforward. Almost exactly like the Mage. So if y'all got any questions, just let me know.